Today I'm painting with Jay, I paint some Terminators, and talk about Adepticon. Hey everyone, welcome back to another Painting with Jay. As always, my name is Jay. So grab a brush, grab some paints, grab some models, paint along with me. Let's rid our world of unpainted models. Today I'm going to work on some yellow painted Deathwing. Some of my Imperial Fists Terminators. I just took some of the Terminators from the starter set for 40k, and I'm going to be painting them up as Imperial Fists, because I really just need more Imperial Fists. I don't really need that many more Deathwing. You know, I have tons of Deathwing. Might as well just do some Terminators for my Imperial Fists. So you're going to notice the models look pretty familiar, but that's okay. We'll paint them yellow. Have a great time doing it. And I'll tell you about Adepticon and my great journey. So let's get started on this week's Painting with Jay. Hey everyone! So, as you can see, I've just started my Terminators. They're the starter set Terminators. And today I'll be working on them, getting them all nice and good. And yeah, that's my goal. I realized that after I started painting these guys, I should have been painting the white first. So I'm going to go and paint their faces first with some white scar. It's an off-white. It's a bluish white. Slightly colder white, I mean. But it'll be okay. And then I'll highlight up with a normal white. But I'll just use this as the foundation color to go over the... And to create a little bit cooler of a tone as well over the yellow. That's okay. And it's really clogged. Perfect. There we go. Excellent. Let's paint their heads with Ghost Rite. And then I will just, maybe I'll give it a shade as well. I haven't decided yet. Where's a good brush that I can use? I gotta get some new brushes. Yeah, definitely gotta get some new brushes. I've been wearing mine out lately. Or painting or something, I don't know. So, let's get these guys. As you can see, it's a nice, thin paint. Now I'll go maybe some soft body black over it. Maybe some blues. These white areas done, and what should I talk about today? But yeah, definitely Adepticon adventures. If you haven't seen my vlog, go check it out. My Adepticon 2018 vlog, it's now up. I had a good time. It was a lot of fun. Yeah, this will work. Sorry, I'm a little bit under the weather. Maybe some con crud or just constantly getting warmer and colder, I guess. That's when I get sick. Then I'll repaint the eyes afterwards with these guys. Once I get the helmets done. And I realized afterwards that I'm so used to painting, you know, the only Terminators I paint are either Deathwing or Grey Knights. So they always have the same helmet color. First time I painted one in a long time that didn't have the same helmet color. So, there you go. Time to just mix things up. There we go. Look at that. A little bit whiter. Good. So yeah, the drive up was good. Let's start talking. The drive up was really good. No problem at the border. Nothing like that one time where I got my car strip searched. It was good. I went by really quickly, the drive. We put some good time behind us. I always like to just put go as, as fast and far as I can go without stopping. That way, I can if I can go like till my car needs gas or just a lunch break, that's good. The only real traffic we hit was at the border for a little bit, and then in Chicago itself was the worst by far. Had a lot of traffic around Chicago, and we went there at like 1 o'clock in the afternoon, and it was crazy traffic. So pretty unavoidable. They were doing a lot of construction or something on the expressway. It happens. This is, I'll clean up the reds after the, or clean up the eyes after I'm done with the helmets. These guys will be my project for the next couple weeks, probably. Well, maybe less than that, until they're done. And then I'll work on maybe a command squad. And yeah. Yeah, I'm slowly working through my Space Marine army. It's been good. It's been good so far. And I did pick up a few Space Marine vehicles at Adepticon at the bits trading. I bought them for a really good price. So I bought a Razorback, a Rhino, and a Vindicator. That'll be good. I'll paint those up. What else did I pick up recently? I bought the digital edition of the Angels of Death supplement because I wanted to try running, new just formations and stuff, which is cool, and it'll be a fun one to run because there are a lot of options that I have now. Yeah, I have a lot of options for my space runs. Eventually, I'd really love to do the full battle company formation and get all the free vehicles. That'd be cool. I just need a bunch of Razorbacks to really do it. So yeah, the drive up was really good. Said nothing too eventful. And then yeah, it was a great time. I hung out mostly with the guys from Death Ray Designs, and I ended up buying a bunch of stuff from their booth because it just looks amazing. I'll be doing a highlight of that stuff in one of my videos, or at least why I'm gonna do a video of all the things I bought at Adepticon. Yeah, it's gonna be good. Their stuff is just really nice. As far as MDF goes, I really, really like it. So if you want to go check their website, definitely feel free. It's deathraydesigns.com, I'm pretty sure. And it just looks awesome. So I can't wait to have that painted up. I'm gonna paint up their terrain and put on my tabletop. It's really awesome. Adam, you missed a spot right there. Yeah.
really fun hanging out with the Death Redesigns guys. You know,
Chris and Adam and Austin and
Kevin.
I didn't even know when I was going up that Mini Wargaming was going up. I didn't know that. So it was fun running into them there. And they all didn't think I was going for some reason. I don't know why. But, yeah, it was really cool. Oh, his face is going to be red on the red white stripe. So maybe I should just do a white stripe. So we'll do that white stripe down the center. And that's that. Good. I'll do another coat quickly. And then I'll do a... Actually, probably worth it just to do a quick soft body black shading and then highlight over it to give it an aged look.
Cool.
So that's drying. I'll get my soft body black out. Yeah, it was really good hanging with them, catching up with Owen and Chris from Mini Wargaming, the Mini Wargaming guys. You know, it's just always cool hanging with them. They're really good guys. And the whole staff was there, you know, Steve and Quirk. Chris, it was really just nice to be able to hang out with my old crew and you know, just talk, you know. What should I do now? Well, white is drying. Maybe I should start on silver areas, because I'm going to use, once again, as always, I'm going to use black as a cleanup color. Those are a little too close to the reds right now. Yeah, let's start painting metallics for a few minutes. Get some metallics done, and then go back, do a soft body black shading on the helmets, and then go from there. I always like to use my gray liner as a cleanup color. Maybe by next week I'll have these guys done. We'll see how much time I have. It felt really good to get those scouts done before I went to Adepticon, so... And of course, what else is happening? Yeah, so, yeah, we hung out with them. During the day, I worked a lot at the Badger booth, helped out Ken. Ken's such a good guy, I like to help him out. And that was fun. And what else? I didn't buy that much. Bought a bunch of Death Ray Design stuff because I just wanted some new terrain. And I figured the Death Ray Designs... it looked like really nice, it goes together nicely, and I'm just stupidly excited to put it together and paint it. So I'll probably, maybe I'll take a week break, couple weeks break, and just paint terrain for my battle reports, or from, you know, yeah, from my coming videos. And that'll be fun. I bought a bust. I've never painted a bust, so I bought one. It was, a limited edition Nemo bust for War Machine, Signar, and that's the only thing I really bought miniature wise. I bought a few vehicles at the swap. I didn't buy any new chibis because I already have a couple chibi miniatures that I left to paint, and I decided that this year, I'm gonna buy a few models this year. I didn't buy really any last year, but. This year, I'm going, you know, trying to get all my models painted, you know, or as many as I can painted. And so, unless I have, you know, no more chibis left, I'm going to not buy any. Like, I'm going to paint all my Space Marines before I buy any more Space Marines, technically. Though I might be purchasing one of the Armageddon box sets, which has a couple squads of Scouts. You know, in case they want to make an all-scout army or something. That'll be cool. I know, they don't look like much right now, but they'll be looking good when they're done. Yeah, they'll be looking good when they're done for sure. Yeah, it was really good just to catch up with them and have a good time. I hung with the Mini Wargaming guys sometimes at night, Death Ray Designs people. I only hung with Michelle Oasis Rising one of the night,
like for a couple hours one night. It was good. Meeting the viewers was amazing. By far, I love just meeting people and talking to them. I only filmed one battle report, which was, this was still a great battle report, against Mikey Vengeance. And it was great. It was Imperial Fists versus Ultramarines. And I'm not going to ruin it. But I brought Librarians, and I had a lot of fun. That's all I'm going to say. Battle Report will be up probably next week. This week's Battle Report was a Battle Report I filmed a little while ago with Trevor. Great game. Great game. So, I'm trying out my Tyranids in Battle Reports again. As you can see by last week's one that I posted was a Tyranid one as well. And then next one obviously is going to be Imperial Fists with Mikey. I just like mixing it up, battle reports and everything. And then I will hopefully, I'm hoping to get Stu, if I have time. And he has time, because he's busy right now. But I'm hoping to get Stu or Dave, or even Trevor could as well, in the future. And film some battle reports for Armageddon, which is the new version of Necromunda. And I have a bunch of different options, because I have a bunch of different armies. It'd be fun to do different campaigns for the or maybe a campaign would be cool or something cool just to do with the game. I love the train as well, so that'll be cool to add to my tabletop as well. And so I'm going to use black as a cleanup color for sure. And just get it all nice and clean. Which will use the symbols, the gaps in the armor. It'll look sweet. Let's stop there. It looks like the white areas are dry, so really dryish. And then I'll hit them with a soft body black from Secret Weapon, and then I'll keep working on the other parts. This is good. I'm just going to talk about my Adepticon, and you know maybe film for the next hour or I guess 45 minutes probably. See how much I can get done in one sitting. Because if I can get these guys done in the next future, in the near future, good. I've also, I've airbrushed and base coated a couple Razorbacks that I will, that I'll be painting in the near future as well. I'm just going to work on my guys first. I decided that. The next few, you know, a couple months, I'll be working on Space Marine stuff. It may not even last me a couple more months. It may just be a month or two. Well, yeah, a month or two, I'd say. Two more months. And then, who knows after that? Yeah. So soft body black. Apply it to the face. I really enjoyed going with my girlfriend. That was really awesome. It was a lot of fun. And it was kind of our first road trip together. And my ex-wife never really went or was interested in my stuff. And so it was really cool. It was awesome. Like, it was a really good time. One of the things she enjoyed the most was the mirrors in the bathroom. They had like really cool anti-fog mirrors that had TVs in them. So she really enjoyed those ones, enjoyed shopping and having a good time, hanging out with the people. Yeah, it was really awesome. I missed Chung. Unfortunately, Chung wasn't there. It was really, he's one of those guys that's just not the same. No, Chung. He's kind of the Chung's always kind of the guy who always knows what's going on, what people are doing, and he's just a great guy. I like to catch up with him, see how he's doing. So, Chung, we missed you. If you're watching this significantly at Adepticon, as I said, I really enjoyed just catching up with Owen and seeing how he's doing, and Chris, seeing how he's doing. Really getting to know Steve. I didn't get to know Steve a lot because I never worked with Steve. Obviously we both worked for the same company, but not at the same time. He works for the company at the moment, and I worked for the company in the past, and I never got to work with him. So it was really cool hanging out with Steve. He's a good guy, really good guy. Mountain of a man, i.e. the mountain. There we go. So now I'll highlight up the cheeks after. Keep that nice and dirty. Nice and dirty. So that's good. Maybe I should put the rest back. I have an ex bit of extra. So that's good. And then what now? Continue working on the metallics. I shouldn't go back to the reds because I'm going to need to fix the reds afterwards. Plus, the helmet of the sergeant will be red. Yeah, I'll do metallics next. Then maybe golds or. I don't know what colors I'm going to use, really. These ones are going to be nice, so I'm just going to do my, my battle report standard and get the map nice and clean, and that's it. And then they'll be good, metal, metal. I could do browns, I guess, afterwards as well. So silver. Silver. I'm going to do this one as rather than a power sword, I'm just going to do it as a normal sword. Why not? I'll do as a normal sword. Just to break up the monotony of it. That's cool. Yeah, these guys are just the guys in the starter set, but I figured, as I said, I have plenty of Deathwing. Might as well paint them up in some Imperial Fist colors and get them, get some Imperial Fist Terminators. Some more variation in my lists. And the more models the less models I have to proxy, the better ultimately for battle reports, right? So what else? I went to some seminars, and I was really lucky with the 40K studio preview. It was really, really hot in that room, though. It was like made me nauseous how hot it was. But it was really cool, and I ended up going to it. And I did already make a video about the rules and the things that I saw. Obviously, there's the Death Watch as well that was shown there, but that was already been shown online. Like GW released that 10 minutes after the seminar, they released the footage of the Death Watch, which is cool. It'll have apparently Mortarion. He's coming back. Mortarion will be a really cool guy to have in the game. So there'll be a Primarch battle, Mortarion versus Gilliman. Seeing Gilliman back in 40K is really cool as well. I think there were several things that I'll talk about that after, but there's several things I'm thinking about after Adepticon. And I'm changing up my videos slightly. I'm going to work on my channel over the next couple weeks and tweak some stuff. And so that'll be good. Yeah, so studio preview, talked about the new rules of 40K. And then I was told by a few people the release date, and as I said, I made a whole video about it. Go check it out on my channel. I'm not going to go too much into that. It was really cool. The things that GW are doing right now and the presence that they had at Adepticon was really cool. Really, really cool. It shows that GW is going right back in the right direction. I'm really confident in this Roundtree guy, their new CEO. He seems to be making a lot of really good decisions. Like they're becoming much more,
they're putting themselves right back into the community again, which is really good to see. They're allowing online retailers to sell their products again, which is good. Very good to see again. And everything that they were telling about joining the community, like getting back in with the community, is just awesome. It's great to see that Games Workshop is doing this stuff. Doing these like little events where they do studio previews and talking about rules, and then they did that Shadow Scepter, remember the game was called? I really wasn't too interested, to be honest. I'm not a Age of Sigmar player, and it was just kind of like Age of Sigmar and like a warband, Age of Sigmar style. So I really wasn't, but nothing against the game. I think that people are going to like the game, providing it gets some good support from the community. They seem to be turning around quite nicely. And they hit that low point where they were losing a lot of people, and I'm hoping that it's not too late to bring some people back into the game. I also got some interesting information that I'll make a video on. It's kind of a downer video, but I really want to talk about Privateer Press. See what I heard I thought was quite interesting, so I'll make a video on that as well. Yeah. I definitely will. I didn't play any Iron Arena. I've never played any of the new edition yet, War Machine or Hordes. So I didn't really find it, fun. I mostly just hung out, chilled with Chris, or chilled with Ken. Sold some airbrush stuff. Just volunteered there, obviously. Booth. I don't actually work at the booth. I just volunteer and help out. That was a really good time. And then I relaxed. I went to breakfast at IHOP a couple times, and oh man, I liked it. The amount of food you get for your price is just insane. And they had a lot of good pancakes. And I went to this Jewish bagel shop as well a couple days in a row. It was good, a little bit cheaper, but it was really good food too. Mm-hmm. Definitely very good food. Perfect. So I gotta finish the whites first, but it's almost done drying. Like it's the soft body black is almost done drying. And then I'll do the silvers on the masks as well afterwards. This is terrific. Not taking me long at all. Then I'll redo the reds. I need to do some of the wiring as well. I'll do that all red. This is coming along. Coming along well, I say. So let's do the brown areas then, I guess. We'll start with that's all drying. I have a bunch of colors in the go, so let's just keep going. More colors in the go. I have some Shabti Bone. Paint the Purity Seals. And then, I don't really know what I'm going to do after that. Just keep painting. As long as my hand has a brush in it, and I'm painting, I'm getting closer to paint. I paint a miniature. That's all I can do. Maybe after this, I'll hit the metallic areas with a shade and go highlight up the white parts. So yeah, I'm really impressed at what GW is doing. They're getting back. And I feel like kind of like me, like I took some time off too. Obviously it wasn't a little different circumstance. It wasn't greed or anything, but and I'm reconnecting. And I hope you find that too. My videos are becoming much more frequent. I've put out so many more videos this year than I did overall, like on average last year. So for free, I already put out like 35, 40 videos. So last year, I only put out like, 80 or 90. That's okay. Look at that. So he's... yeah, I'll do the ropes all red as well.
What else? The other event I went to was a really cool discussion. It was a rules seminar with Robin Krudos from Games Workshop. He was kind of notorious for writing some pretty, I'd say some pretty bad codices. He wrote like one of the, I guess, Imperial Guard, and he wrote Tyranids. But yeah, it was really cool discussing the way that they write their rules. What's the process? And I naturally assumed, wrongly, that the rules come first because, you know, there have been a bunch of models in the past that have rules but no models, you know, or not for a while. Especially, you know, a bunch of codices used to have several named characters or squads that didn't have any models, and then eventually the models would come out and be like, yeah, that's awesome, you know, I have models. There's no purity seals in that guy. That's not the case. It's actually, these days, it's the models typically come first, and then they come up with a backstory. And some, I didn't do the metallics on this guy. Oops. So I'll do the silvers on him. But they typically are inspired by the sculptors. The sculptors create a model, and then they write rules and a background story for it. So that's kind of interesting. Very opposite of what I thought it would be. And they were talking about a few of the newer, you know, newer models that might come out. I'll switch back quickly to metallic so that I can get this all the steps done. I have a lot. I don't normally have this many colors going at a time, but that's okay. We'll get it all done eventually, right? So that was really cool. And then talking about the rules, what their plans are a bit for 40K and Age of Sigmar, how they talk about balance. Now, balance is a weird issue, especially seeing as that one of the most overpowered codices recent or supplements just came out. You know, Gathering Storm 2 with the Inari is just crazy powerful. Speaking of which, I'm definitely going to start getting back into codex reviews or books reviews. If I get a copy of Armageddon, expect that one for sure. Definitely will. I will definitely start doing codex reviews. I really should have done that a long time ago, with especially with the Inari, and like I should have been already on that, and I kick myself for not being on it. Frankly, I should be on that. But oh man, Inari is powerful. Really powerful. So it's interesting hearing them talk about balance. So I'm like, really? Your balance isn't there right now, you know. Certain armies are still significantly more powerful than any other. And it's seen in the tournament scene. But it's cool hearing them talk and try to like defend themselves about codexes and balance and internal balance, external balance, the way that they come up with the rules to make the game cool. And I know that the game, their mission is to make a cool game with awesome miniatures, and that's true. It's not the most balanced game, but it's definitely cool, a lot of fun for me to play. They're talking about, you know, what their ambitions are for Maelstrom War missions, and that's really cool. You know, they would love to have different ways of interacting with the cards and maybe making your own deck kind of thing, and a few different options there. But it was nice meeting like a lot of the Games Workshop guys. Like, even Duncan was there. Of course, everyone was talking about, you know, the two thin coats joke. Robin Krudos was there. Jess from their rules team as well was there. It was just really cool seeing Games Workshop, and also Mini Wargaming was there. So it was really cool. Some of the bigger names were actually giving Adepticon the respect it deserves and being a part of it. You know, I always thought Mini Wargaming should have gone to Adepticon since they're one of the biggest channels. No, they're the biggest channel in miniature wargaming, and it's the biggest wargaming convention in North America. So they should have been there. I'm glad that they went there this year. You know, I'm really glad that they did. I even hooked up Dave one of the nights with one of the event
Sorry, I just gotta grab a drink. My throat's really dry. With one of the people who run Adepticon. So, we'll see what Mini Wyrmwind does next year. Oh. So, what should I do now? Yeah, let me take some soft body black. Or not some ghost white. Highlight up the let me just do a quick highlight of the faces. And then we'll start back on the reds. Yeah. And go from there. Yeah. That was really cool. Very cool seeing them there. It always goes by so quickly, you know? It does. And it's unfortunate how fast it goes by. But I had a great time. Highlight for me is always just meeting people and hanging out with them. Like, unfortunately, I didn't get to see Black Tom for, I saw him for a few minutes. But Black Tom, was awesome seeing you again. And next time we definitely gotta, I agree, we gotta set some time aside so that we can hang out. Next year, I really do think I'm gonna try to enter I said this last year, but I think I really wanna enter a Crystal Brush entry, like a serious entry next year. Well, I'll actually push myself for a period of time to actually do it. It'd be cool to see how I can push my painting skills. And I already know what category I gotta go. I gotta try chibi because it's my favorite category. Of course, I'm up against the man, the legend, Mark Maxey, who very much deservedly won this year. I loved his miniature. It's Davy Jones chibi. It looks kind of like I already did the eyes with the dots in them. That's cool. I haven't, so I'll clean that up after. Maybe I can just paint around it. 2 for 1. Yeah, it was really good hanging out with people. And as I said, thank you all you for such an awesome time at Adepticon. It's always hard the next couple days when you're back into life and reality from a convention. And all you think about is the next convention. You know? That's all I can think about. And it was a lot of fun. Great time. It's always well run, well organized. I'm glad this year they didn't overbook the hotel. Next year's date's already been released, so that's good. And yeah, so I'll definitely, next year I'll probably go VIG. This year the VIG packages were really awesome. So if I have the chance next year, I'll go VIG. Good. I like these a little bit dirtier. That really works. Good. I'm gonna keep them a little dirtier. Yeah. VIG's got like hard cases this time. It's pretty awesome. And Rune Wars.
So. Yeah, that's good. The Crystal Rush entries were really good this year. The Space Wolf, that one was cool. I didn't know it would win distinctively. I thought there were several that could win this year. Of course, this is Space Wolf, so Space Marines, right? And the thing is, it is based on public vote, and so if you do Space Marines, and you do Space Marines really, really, really well, you have a good chance of winning. Because it is half public vote, so. My favorite was probably the Alice in Wonderland. Not Alice in Wonderland, Wizard of Oz one. It's a really interesting, like, dark gothic Wizard of Oz. So, that was cool. But yeah, the way that the painters just push the boundaries of art in the art form of miniature painting is just crazy to me. Like, they just make everything look so amazing. Very much so. By no means am I saying I'm on the same wavelength as them, but I would love to just push myself and try it. You know, no expectations, just relaxing and take my time on a miniature and paint it really well to a standard that I don't ever really go to. That one too? I think it was. Yep. Cool. And I'll go back to the reds after this and work on the reds. Because, yeah, a lot of red as well that I haven't done on the model. But as I said, black will be my cleanup color. Maybe I should do the, no, I could do silvers as well afterwards. Yeah. Get all the reds done. There's not going to be that many colors in these guys. Because of the, you know, their Imperial Fists. Good. Let's go back to the reds. So, let's get the reds all done. And then finish up that today. I don't know what time. What are we at? 42 minutes. Yeah, so not too much left. What else? Yeah, it was cool. I love just the late night hangouts, just talking and relaxing. And it's just really great to see these people that you don't normally get to see outside of conventions. There were a bunch of YouTubers there, like Adam from Tabletop Minions, and Mini Wargaming was there, Owen and Chris and yeah. It's really good seeing them, and it's always cool. Like, I know my channel, I've taken a lot of time off last year, but I'm working hard again, and I still feel like I'm one of the more productive YouTubers in our niche. Like, I really do think that. Like, I work hard, and I'm still, you know, in the higher, you know, subs and views per month, and it's really cool to see that. I worked really hard, and my hard work is still paying off. And of course, I'm going to continue to work hard. That's the beauty of it. I can
keep working hard, bring my channel. I'm hoping that my channel is not, I don't think it is. I had a lot of conversations and I have some ideas of what I want to do, a few different things differently with my channels, specifically the Warp with a lot of them, but how I'm going to just tweak things for free and hopefully keep everything just going. And it's the motivation as well. I love the motivation that you get after a con is just amazing. Yeah, I'm going to hit that with a small shade as well. The motivation you get after a convention of meeting people and hanging out with viewers and just, it's just amazing. Like, you feel like a million bucks. Good. So that's red. Is there any rope? Nope. Oh yeah, there's a little bit of rope. You feel great and you get that motivation again to come back and want to make videos. Last week I just posted my vlogs and there's still one more video left of all the, I call it my Adepticon booty, I think it's called. But also I got an Adepticon just to show some of the new products I picked up. And yeah, I can't wait to keep making videos for you all, you know, and you know that I'm gonna have some Terminators soon for my Imperial Fists. I'm excited. What's the other thing? Yeah, it was just really awesome. Great time. Great time. The weather was insane. The Friday of the Adepticon was like 23 Celsius, high 70s or 80s Fahrenheit. 70s. It was really good. Really good weather. Couldn't have asked for better. And it rained a little bit, but who cares? You know, it rains a bit. I had an amazing time. I'm really glad to be back, working hard, making content. You know, it's only today's Tuesday, and I'm filming Painting with Jay because I was just really in the mood to come out here and paint. I want to get these Terminators done. Get her done. Get her on the table, you know? And that way, then another space, you know, another squad is done. And I'm going to keep going just hardcore with my painting. I'm challenging myself that this year, I'm going to pick up for all that, the painting I missed last year. And if I can get all my space remodels done, then I'll turn to either add, probably do maybe Necrons for like a week or two, getting them all done and nice, and then work on maybe my ad mech army. Yeah, sure. Maybe the ropes in front of the symbol. I can differentiate them with shades and highlights. Maybe I should do a quick hazard line pattern on the on his, yeah, I'll do that on his chain fist. This is Imperial Fist after all. Look at that. Most of their symbols are going to be black. Black's going to be a huge part of this. I'll do that symbol gold. Black.
of strings done. Look at that. They're coming along, right? They're just color by color. You work hard, paint for an hour. I have the feeling, now this weekend I'm not going to see my girlfriend until probably Sunday. Saturday night or Sunday. So, I will be... probably painting a bit. If I do, these guys will be done. They'll definitely be done before next week, and they'll be good. Yeah, look at that. Reds are done. Reds are done. Next one. 50 minutes. It goes by so quickly. Yeah, so very quickly. But it's okay. And you turn around and you got painted models. You're ridding your world of unpainted models, right? That's what we're doing. And we're doing it together. That's all good. I'm excited to bring my channel back to where it once was. I really am. And it's this hard work and determination that will do it. It really will. I'm confident that I can. You know, I really do think I can. And if I can't, well, I tried. You know, that's what I can do. I can try. And these guys are going to be awesome. I got a painted squad of the Terminators, and then, yeah, probably Command Squad next. I think that'll be an easy one. I'll assemble them, get them all done. After the Command Squad, probably I'll start working on some vehicles, because I'm out of, well, I do have a couple more. If I do end up buying the Armageddon, I'll have two more squads of scouts, but, to be honest, I probably just want to work on some vehicles. I think I'm going to try to paint all my Space Marines before going to another another army. Yeah. Because that way I can just dedicate myself to painting Imperial Fists. I will have like 4,000 or 5,000 points, I'm guessing. Imperial Fist, probably by the time this is done. Maybe not. Maybe I'm over. Probably 4,000. Maybe. I don't know. I still have a drop pod. And, drop pod. Three Razorbacks. A Rhino. A Vindicator. That's a good amount of points there. Command squad, so it depends on how I load them out. I'll definitely put an apothecary in there. And what else? Two squads of scouts. And then I'll do an army showcase. Yeah, definitely an army showcase of how all my Space Marines, show off all my work. This is probably months away because I have a bunch of guys. But my Space Marines are actually where the majority of my models left are to be unpainted. Orcs I have a bunch too, and Tyranids I have a bunch. But I'm not painting Tyranids until a new codex drops, because there's no point. And orcs are kind of what I'd work on after my ad mech, I think. Because I have so many orc boys right now, and there's very few things that I could paint that would add new, interesting combinations to my army that I have right now. Other than a battle wagon and a really cool vehicle that Cody Ruins made for me that I've been working slowly but surely on. Probably gonna work on the rest of the reds. Yeah, let's finish up the reds and then we will call it a night, because I don't really want to quit in the middle of the, or at least the rest of the Mephiston red, and then we'll call it a night, because I don't want to end the middle color. But there's the next, I may go to this model. This guy will be done, and yeah, once I get the washes done, like, there's not that many colors to a Terminator, so the big colors left are gold, and then the black, and the black will be really the cleanup color, as I typically do, and it will clean up most of the areas. Most of the symbols that are remaining will be black. I gotta finish the brown on the purity seals, and yeah, this is after an hour. Like, if you look at the amount of stuff I did in the last hour, while talking and rambling, not bad at all. Not bad at all. Apparently a teaser. Yeah, I saw the teaser today for the next, the Defenders. Cool. Oh, good. I wasn't the biggest fan of Iron Fist. It wasn't bad, but I like Luke Cage better. Yeah, there were some good pros to it, but I just, some cons as well. Wasn't the most interesting storyline. A lot of stalling. Didn't seem like it had a lot of work to go on. Could have been half the number of episodes and would have been just as good, I don't know. Look at him. So he's almost done. The reds. And then it's just a lot of shading that I'll need to do before shading before next week's episode. If these guys are even on, maybe by next week I'll have the next squad assembled and ready to paint as well. Look, another one done. Probably gonna call up to this guy. I don't think I really want to start. No, it's 58, and this guy's gonna have a lot of reds on him. Yeah, he will. A lot of reds. So. I got some stuff done. Definitely got some stuff done. Obviously, they're nowhere near complete, but they're coming along. They're definitely coming along. So let's end here. So that was it. A lot of fun. I painted for an hour. Now I'm just going to take a break for the night. I'll return tomorrow. I think I should get another hour in tomorrow. And after another hour,
they'll be well on their way, because I'm almost on the reds. When I get on the reds, you know, shaded, highlighted up, then I'm just going to keep going from there. Hopefully by next week, I just have some finished pictures on my Facebook page, and then it'll be time to start the command squad. It'll be a lot of fun. So let's keep going, and painting in life. Let's just keep going, keep painting, having a great time. So thank you as always for painting along with me. As always, this is a free content video. So a huge thank you to all my Patreon subscribers. As you can see, their names go by my head. It's because of them that I can keep doing my free content for you all. And I really hope you enjoyed this week's content and painting along with me. So stay tuned for more videos. Talk to you soon. This is Jay saying happy painting with me.